Fasting 101. Fasting is the best way you can heal yourself. You don't need to take anything. There's dry fasting, which I've done several of those. Usually for 3 days. And then there's water fasting. Water fasting is easier. It can be prolonged more than a dry fast. I can make this video so much better. But I'm You don't need to take anything when you fast. Especially water dry fasting. The reason why I'm even saying all this is so you can heal yourself. A lot of people are unaware you don't need someone to conduct your fast. It may be easier in certain circumstances, like, for instance, if you're around a bunch of people that are fasting with you, that you know, and enjoy, and are comfortable around. And make the fast probably easier. But then again, it's all personal preference. kids. Are always happy. If they're nurtured and loved. But even so, they're mostly happy all the time. And my perspective of this is, because after a while, though, the toxins accumulate in your body. So, hence why it could be harder to be happy. Especially when you get older. Aging's not exactly what you think. You shouldn't be worried about how long you're gonna live. More the fact what you want to do now in your health for the moment being. Fasting's the best way to cure yourself. And it will give you things you could never even imagine. Spirituality, for sure. It's a direct route. That's why I encourage it. Also, when you fast, preferably, I'd want to do it in warm climates. It'd be way easier. And being outside too. Depending on how you feel. You're gonna get really bored during the fast. Especially if you're dry fasting. So be prepared. Also, a lack of energy. But you'll have springs of energy. And all those springs of energy you should move. Also would go away very quick. People want the truth. This is the truth. like I said, you don't need anyone to supervise your fast. Do what your body tells you. If you really think you're not gonna make it, then I would stop. If you want a rough guideline, dry fasting I would go for 3 days. Four is pushing it. If you're really hydrated. Water fasting, I would say up to 10 days, even 14. Would be good. 14 would be pushing it. If you're not exactly sure, and depending on how you feel, of course you can go longer on both of those. But this is people that want a rough guideline. Fasting will cure you. You should definitely do it. I'm going to talk about my experiences in another video. But my longest water fast, which I've only really done one, and it was just like last week, and I also wanted to film myself when I did my dry fast. But on top of me not feeling good, the energy wasn't there. Dry fasting, you might actually have to push yourself. Whereas water fasting, which mine was for 6 days, water fasting's definitely easier. And it all depends what your problem is. My body would shake every time that I would sip water. It still does. That's why I did dry fasting first. I was afraid to drink water. And this just ties in what else I was saying in my other video, Health is Wealth. My body's afraid to drink water. Which then causes a thought in my mind, a fear drinking water. You see how it stems together? Not too many people have a mind issue as much as they do as a body issue, which should be like the thing that we're taught. Thanks everyone, and I hope you have a blessed day. Spread the message. Do what you want with it. But this is the truth. And the direct truth. I love everybody. And everything. And I wish you farewell on your health. Thank you.